We learned about effective communication, verbal communication, barriers in communication, and also about levels of listening and different kinds of communicators. So to know, get ready to know more today. So over to you, Richa.
Thank you so much, Spandana. Very good morning, everybody. Subrat, Mayuri, how are you all doing today? Subrat, Mayuri, I hope you all are able to hear me, see me. Okay. I hope I'm audible, Subrat and Mayuri. I hope you all can see me and hear me. Okay, so Mayuri, I want to check with you first before we move on with the session regarding yesterday's session. Let's quickly do a recap. What were some of the learnings from the session yesterday? What are some of the key takeaways from yesterday's session? Would you like to highlight some of them, please? Mayuri, we are not able to hear you, though you are on. You are unmuted, but still we are not able to hear it. Any technical challenges on your end? Then you can probably put it into the chat box. Subrat, are you? Will you be able to tell us what were your takeaways from the session yesterday? What did you learn in yesterday's session? Yes, Mayuri, we understood about what are the barriers. Barriers for what? What barriers were we talking about? Communication, right? So barriers to communication. Very good. What else did we discuss yesterday?
Proper structuring of the speech
Yes.
and the pauses that we have to take
Yes.
and how to be an effective speaker.
All
Then
right.
the tone matters a lot when you speak. That
That's
exercise we did and what else? I guess that's all I can remember.
Yes, that's about it. Yes. So what we did yesterday was we covered on verbal communication. We understood what is communication, how to make your communication a two-way process rather than a one-way process. We also spoke about the six steps of what exactly is a communication. So from sender, receiver point of view, there's a feedback, there are barriers. We discussed about certain barriers to communication. We also spoke about key components for communication like listening. So we spoke about how important it is to listen to people and how communication is not just about talking. Communication is also about listening to others and how you can be an empathetic and an attentive listener. We also spoke about the tone, the right pauses, the intonation, and how to make your communication more impactful so that you are able to make a impression on the receiver's mind, whether it's communication face to face, whether it's through a speech, whether through its presentation, or it's through an email. So we also spoke about the seven C's of communication, wherein we understood how you can make your communication more concise, precise, and make it more coherent, make it more courteous, and all of those things which make a communication very, very structured. Okay. Now, moving on from yesterday to today, today being the last day of the session, what we are going to cover is a very, very important module, which is known as attitude. Okay, now before we move on to today's session, I would want you to so remember yesterday I had spoken about a small assignment that I had wanted you all to redo on your passion. Yes, so I wanted you all to redo that and give us a presentation very quickly for 1 or 2 minutes about how you can talk about this topic of my passion, taking into consideration whatever we had learned yesterday. Okay, so Subrat, would you like to start?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay. So
Mayuri, please be ready next. Okay. Yes,
again,
Subrat.
I'll have to read a bit because it's hard to remember all these lines.
Sure.
Okay. Imagine doing something that you love and getting paid for it. Isn't that amazing? A very warm welcome to to each and every listener. I am Subrat. And in the next couple of minutes, I'll be shedding some light on following your passion. Passion is a state of mind where you tend to develop interest towards a hobby or unconventional artistic things that never bores you. Many people dream to pursue a career in the field that they are passionate about, such as music, dance, photography, acting, sports, etc. But the sad reality says that 60% of them end up being financially unstable. In today's world, there are several open learning platforms that can provide you an insight of the career and would eventually help the student to realize that whether to take the risk or not. Okay, I have a question for the listeners. How many of you have a hobby?
I do, yes.
What kind of a hobby do you have?
I love working out. So I'm a fitness freak. I love to work out. Sometimes I work out 3 times a day. Sometimes it just depends on, you know, how pepped I am for the day. So I love working out, whether it's jogging, cycling, swimming, whatever it is.
Okay, so let's suppose you have a hobby of working out. And if you wish to pursue your career in fitness, will you be able to convince your family for that? Because that is also a great challenge in the process. Right.
Yes.
So the other aspect of those challenges is the financial insecurity that can be caused by unorganized and unplanned career paths. So eventually following your passion can be made easy and effective if you do the right drill. Conclusively, I'd like to say that believe in yourself, practice, plan, and pursue. Thank you for being so patient, and do have a hobby and do follow your passion. Thank you.
Very nice, Subrat. Good job.
Thank you, ma'am.
All right. I believe from yesterday to today, there was a huge improvement, which I could see, Subrat. Whatever I had asked you to work on, and you know, your areas of improvement, I could see that you have given it the complete transition from yesterday to today. So excellent opening, very good way of engaging the audience, like how you asked a question. Now this is very important, okay, because otherwise the audience will be, you know, not very physically present, but again mentally absent. So it's a good idea to ask them questions in the middle of your presentation or speech. I also like the way you went slower than how you were yesterday. So, you know, you paused at the right place. There was a line wherein I had asked you to slow down. You did that also. The fluency, your structure, the way you spoke, very fluent and very, very structured well. I think overall it was just a good package. Yes, I don't think there was anything missing here. It was really well done. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you.
All right, Mayuri, over to you. Let's have you. Would you be able to put on your camera, Mayuri?
Hello, ma'am. Good morning. I am Mayuri Sonone. I like the use of word, passion, interchangeably with world, like determination, conviction, and love. Passion is a strong desire that can get you do amazing things. Passion is an emotion to be acted upon without action. Passion yield no worthwhile result. Passion is the fuel in the fire on action. Where you have passion for something, you love it even when you hate it. Thank you.
Okay. Mayuri, it was nice, but it was feeling like you're just reading through. Okay. It was looking scripted. You understand scripted? Matlab aisa hai ki आपने पूरा रट लिया था एंड देन यू आर जस्ट टेकिंग इट आउट यू नो सो दैट इज अ कंसर्न स्पेशली व्हेन यू वांट टू गेट इनटू यू नो व्हेन यू वांट टू मेक अ गुड इंप्रेशन एंड एन इम्पैक्टफुल प्रेजेंटेशन सो यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट यू आर यू नो योर दो यू माइट बी रीडिंग इट बट एड योर फ्लेवर टू इट एड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ यू नो ड्रामा टू इट ओके आस्किंग अ क्वेश्चन लाइक यू नो यू आर एज इफ द ऑडियंस इज एक्चुअली सिटिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड यू आर आस्किंग देम अ क्वेश्चन सो It has to be a little bit more energetic, enthusiastic, in your voice tone. It should not look a monotone. Like I believe yesterday also I told you the same thing, that it was sounding very monotonous. You have to break the monotony by putting in a little bit of extra zing to it. Okay, so make it a little bit more communicative, I would feel, rather than a one-way communication. Make it like a two-way communication. Ask a few questions in the middle, like you saw how Subhra did. Make it a good opening and a closing. So closing also, Mayuri, bahut abrupt ending kar diya tha apne. Apne closing ko thoda sa, like, you know, how you can probably end with a quotation, end with a nice statement, something like that. Or, you know, just thank people for listening to you. So these are good etiquette, you know, you can have in your speech. Yes?
Okay.
So it was good, but then I believe there is a lot of scope for improvement, and I know you can do it. Okay. You have it in you. You just have to make it a little bit, practice it a little bit more. Okay. All right. Thank you. Do we have Umang with us? Has she joined? I don't see her. And even Bhargav is not there, right, today. Okay. Spandana or somebody else, Sonal, probably one of you can just check with Umang if she's joining in or no. It's already 10:16. And Bhargav also, I believe he was supposed to join back on today's day. Like he said he'll be coming back on Friday. So, okay. All right. Moving on from here, let us, as I mentioned to you all before, we will today talk about attitude. Okay. I hope you all can see my screen. Oh, sorry. Just give me a second. Okay. So today we're going to talk about attitude. And before I start speaking about it, I would like to understand from you, from both you, Subhra and Mayuri, what is your understanding about attitude?
According to me, attitude is a perception of your thought process about things, mm-hmm. or your perception about how you react to things, how you perceive things, I guess.
Yes, very good. It's the way you, in which you perceive things. Okay. Thank you for sharing that, Subrat. And how about you, Mayuri? What do you understand by the word attitude?
Manner, disposition, feeling, and position.
Sorry, giving?
Manner, disposition, feelings, and position.
Okay, now that's sounding like a dictionary meaning of attitude right now. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's the way you perceive things, is the way you think about certain things. Now, if I may ask both of you, how do you feel this attitude comes across? I mean, when does it start? Are there any factors governing when this attitude starts building up on a person?
The circumstances in which either a person succeeds or fails, or, you know, any major event takes place that might change the attitude of the person.
Okay.
Or, you know, in the company you're staying with, the people you're staying with.
Absolutely. Very well said. Yes, Subrat. So the circumstances, the people whom you are around with right from your childhood, you know, so you see your parents around you, you see your teachers, you see, you know, various company of people around you. So that starts, you know, building up on an attitude of the person. Your perception towards the outside world is governed by your circumstances or your experiences that you have grown up with. Okay. Now, can attitude be learned? Can you learn an attitude? Or is it given that whatever you have been born with, whatever that circumstances or situations around, that only is the final attitude that a person may have in life? Is that so? Or can you learn an attitude even at a later stage in life? What do you all
say? I believe that attitude is a behavioral thing that can be changed at any point of life. There are some things that are embedded priorly, but we can obviously make changes in our life according to the situation.
Yes, very well. So we can make situation, we can make, you know, changes to attitude later on also in life. It's not that ek bar ek attitude ho gaya, so you live with it the whole, you know, the, your whole lifetime. It's not like that. So it is definitely, it's a skill that you can learn. Now, there is a difference between attitude and behavior, which I will come to a little in the later slides. But there is a difference between attitude and behavior for sure. Okay, we'll come to that in a while. So we'll start with a small assessment for attitude. I'm going to share the screen with you right now. There are about 15 questions over here. You have to just read through this and give yourself a scoring. 3 is always, 2 is more than half the time, 1 is occasionally, and 0 is never. So just take about 5 minutes and read the sentence. Whatever first thing comes to your mind, put the number of that. Do not overthink, otherwise you will not do this properly. Okay. Sivrat, what is the score you got?
38.
And how about you, Sivrat?
I just got 38.
You got 38. Sorry, Sivrat. I'm talking about Mayuri now.
34.
Okay, 34 and 38. All right. So let's take a look at what your attitude or this your self-esteem or your self-confidence is regarding, you know, for you. Okay, so if you're falling under 38 to 45, it means that you have a high self-esteem, you are confident about yourself and your abilities, and you genuinely have a strong self-esteem for yourself. Okay, self-esteem to a large extent you know, shows our attitude in life. If you are somebody who has a positive and a strong self-esteem and a self-confidence, then you will show that in your attitude also. Okay, so Sivrat, you fall between 38 to 45, and that's what you are. Your self-esteem is high about yourself. Okay, you're confident in your abilities. So good over there. Mayuri, you fall under 32-37. You are generally confident about yourself and your abilities, and you tend to remain positive and optimistic in your attitude. Do you think both of you all, that's true about you?
Actually, ma'am, that was not true. If we were talking about 2 years from now.
Okay.
I have changed in the lockdown.
Lovely. So 2 years back you were different, but today you are a different person, and today you're falling under the high self-esteem category wherein you are confident about yourself and your abilities, right?
Yes.
Okay, great. Mayuri, what about you? Do you feel you are falling under the right category?
Yes, ma'am.
Fantastic. So that is how, so I'll not go to the rest of them because we don't have any participants who are falling under these categories, the rest of them. But what we are trying to actually see is through these questions, if you are really honest when you're answering them, then you will definitely get the right scoring and you will know that you're falling under which category. Okay. So self-esteem is very important, friends. It's something that will really make you a good, make you shine like a good personality. People who have great personality or have great leadership skills today are people who really are confident about themselves. You put them into any situation, they get out of it. They don't crib and complain and they don't, think about aisa hota to kaisa hota, I should have had done this and I regret doing this and I'm guilty about this thing. No, there are people who accept them the way they are and they are very, very confident about themselves, irrespective of their negative or the weaknesses that they may have. Okay, so that's why attitude in life is very, very important, because only if you have the right attitude can you succeed in life. Okay. And that's the reason a lot of people who are into motivation, who want to, really have a good attitude are self-motivated people. Okay. So that's very, very important character to have. So what is an attitude? An attitude is a negative or a positive evaluation of an object which influences human behavior. And an attitude is a learned predisposition to respond in a favorable or unfavorable manner, either towards a people or object or an idea or a situation. Now, I'm just going to highlight one thing over here. Your attitude in life is going to determine how much you're going to succeed in life. Okay. Imagine there are two people, okay, in their childhood days, they went through the same situation. It could be two siblings, two brothers or two sisters or brother, sister, whatever. They grew up in the same environment at home, wherein probably things were not really good at home. It could have been a broken home or whatever it could be the situation. Now, one sibling turns out, really successful in life, probably has learned from these things, from the experiences at home, and has decided that that's not going to determine his or her destiny. And the second sibling reacts in a different attitude way, wherein he says, this is my life, this is how I've been growing up, and this is going to determine me as a adult or as a human being later on in life. So two people can be in the same situation, but they can have a different attitude completely altogether about that situation or that particular environment that they have grown up in. And I also believe this is very, very true, that you are an average of five people you spend your maximum time with. Okay. So keep good company. The five people whom you're closest to. Okay. It could be a family member. It could be a friend. It could be a sibling, whoever. But the five closest people in your life determine the kind of attitude you will have in life. If you stay around people who are naysayers, what do I say? But mean by naysayers, people who are always putting you down, or I always, saying ye nahi ho sakta hai, wo nahi ho sakta hai, you can't do that, you can't do this. So they are naysayers. They have not achieved anything in their life, and that's the reason they put you also down, right? So if you stay in a company of that kind of people, that's the attitude that you will also get. But on the other hand, if you stick around people who are really positive in nature, who are always enthusiastic, energetic about life, who don't complain, who just accept life the way it is, who are goal-oriented, etc. If you spend, your time around that kind of company, trust me, your life will be something completely different. Okay. So you are an average of five people whom you spend your maximum time with. And that's why see the company, be very careful about the kind of company you keep. Okay. Make sense?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
All right. Thank you. So going forward, what is attitude? Attitude is your state of mind. Your attitude is your mindset. What you think about certain things, whether you think positively, negatively, favorably, non-favorably, whatever it is about people, objects, situations. Some people say, aisa hi hoga life mein mere saath, because mere saath aisa hi hota hai. Now, what kind of a statement is mere saath aisa hi hota hai? That person has accepted failure in life and that person feels ki mere saath kuch achha ho hi nahi sakta hai. Okay, so that's a mindset. That's a prejudice mindset, which makes a person thinking, this is my destiny and that's how it's going to. The truth is that you make your own destiny. You carve your own path for yourself. Okay. Nobody has the power to take anything from you if you don't give them the power to do that. So you have to be confident about yourself, and everything I feel is in your hand. If you ever get to read, I don't know whether you might have read The Secret book or watched the movie. Anybody?
I have read the book, but I don't remember since I read it about 5 years ago, I guess.
Okay. If you get a chance, Subrat and Mayuri, both of you read the book, The Secret. It's amazing. The kind of things that the author has shared is really going to blow your mind. Yeah. So if you get a chance, do read that book again, Subrat and Mayuri, both of you.
The Secret by Rhonda Byrne, right?
Absolutely.
Yes, yes I have read the book.
Yes. So it just changes your perception about things, and it tells you that you are in control of your life and you are in control of your destiny. And if you decide on something, nobody can take it away from you. You just have to have that willpower and the determination, and things will just fall into place. It also talks about affirmations, you know, positive affirmations that you can do in your life. The moment you wake up, you know, declare to the world what your positive affirmations are. And it's energy. It's all about the kind of energy that you have, you know. The energy you give out is the energy you receive. So we all are living in this world where everything is vibrational, everything is energy, right? So I'm not going to get too much into it, otherwise I'll digress from the point. But given a chance, please go ahead and read that book. I think there is also a movie on it. Watch that if you can. So attitude is your state of mind. It's your mindset. It's the way you look at things mentally. And your attitudes are your evaluative statements. You know, the statements that you say, mere saath aisa hi hoga. I'm not good in maths. I'm not good in this. I can never lose weight. These are evaluative statements. Means aapne already judge kar liya hai apne aapko, and you are saying that aloud to the universe. Okay. So it expresses individuals' positive or negative feelings about the same object. Okay, can attitude be learned? Yes, we've already said that you can learn it. It's something like a skill which can be developed. Is attitude contagious? Like the virus? What do you all say? Is it contagious?
Yes, definitely. It is.
It is, definitely. Yes. So you have to be very, very careful. If you don't want to catch the wrong kind of attitude, you have to stay, far away from such kind of people. Okay. All right, going forward, we were talking about attitude versus behavior. But before we do that, I want to show you a small video. Do you know what is something so special about the animal lion and eagle? Let's talk about lion. Do you know what's so special about the lion?
About the lion, the best thing that I feel... nobody else knows that who's the king. Nobody else thinks like they are the king, but lion has that king mentality, that royal mentality. That's why he's the king, known as the king of the jungle.
Yes, very true. And Mayuri, how about you? What do you feel? What's so different about the lion? Mayuri, are you there? Yeah, she's there. Okay, you can put it into the chat box in case you're facing technical difficulties. Yes, so the attitude of the lion is, lion is not the fastest animal, right? Is he? No. He is not the strongest. He's not like the heaviest or the strongest or the most powerful. No. But the attitude of the lion is such that he believes in himself, saying that, yes, I am the king of the jungle. And he has that aura about him. The rest of the people, the animals around him, fear the lion. That's the kind of energy, that's the kind of vibrancy the lion gives out, right? So it's not that the lion is the fastest, the most powerful, is the most healthiest or whatever, but the fact is, the attitude of the lion is that the self-confidence that the lion has, that I am the king of the jungle, and everybody believes that around him, right? So about the eagle, similar to that, okay, but I'm going to share the video with you first so that I don't give away any more. Give me a second. Okay, I hope you all can see my screen. Let us start with Subrat and Mayuri. Either one of you can take the lead and share the points with us, please.
Sure, ma'am. In the positive points, we have a positive approach, taking the initiative, leadership qualities, honesty, team playing, kind-hearted, respectful, responsible, responsive, confident.
Go a little slow.
Soft-spoken, mm-hmm. well-behaved, fearless, independent, charming, well-organized, encouraging, dependable, mm-hmm. friendly, generous, polite, and a good decision maker.
Okay, thank you. And how about you, Mayuri?
Low emotional, chronic sarcasm, inflexibility, not following through, lacking empathy, being a control freak, being close-minded, mm-hmm. constant complaining, managing with fear.
So these are the negative attitudes that people have, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So now when you have the positive and the negative attitude, where do you identify yourself most with? So if you, as Subrat, if you feel when you're looking at the positive sides or when you were discussing the negative attitude, what do you feel? What's your attitude like? Is it more, on the positive side, or if you feel you are a little inclined towards the negative side, what do you feel?
Well, mine is, I would say, currently in the positive side.
Okay, fantastic. And Mayuri, how about you?
Both positive and negative.
Both. Absolutely. So thanks for the honesty over here. Definitely. At times, what happens is we try to have that positive attitude, but sometimes the situations around us are not very, are very challenging. And at times we tend to get a little towards the negative side, right? But what we have to do as individuals, as humans, as we have to keep pulling ourselves back to the positivity. Okay. So always remember your why. What's your why in life? If your why is clear, your what and how will automatically follow through. If you ever get a chance, listen to Simon Sinek. He's one of the famous motivational speakers and author and psychologist. And, he's really good with whatever he speaks. So his name is Simon Sinek. Okay. So he describes this golden circle. Okay. Now, golden circle, in the middle, there is a why. And then there is a how and a what. So what he says is that if you know what's your why, what's your purpose, what's your why, if you're clear on that, the what and the how will follow through automatically. They will fall into place, but you need to be clear about your why. So every time you feel you're slipping into the negative side, pull yourself back by asking what's restating to yourself, what's your why? Okay, so why are you here? What is your purpose is what will help you get back into the positivity. All right, makes sense?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, moving on from here. Remember, we were speaking about attitude and behavior, right? A little while back. So how is attitude and behavior different from each other? So let's take a look at the comparison between attitude versus behavior. Now, attitude refers to a person's mental view regarding the way he or she thinks or feels about someone or something. That's your mental framework. You think about a person in a particular manner or a situation about in a particular manner. But vis-a-vis the behavior is the action. Okay. Behavior is always about your moves, your conduct, or your functional, aspect towards a person or towards a group of people. So behavior is the action. Attitude is your thinking versus action. Okay. Now, what is attitude based on? It's based on your experiences and your observation. You know, how whatever you have observed as a child in your home or whatever your experiences have taught you is what your attitude is. And behavior is primarily driven by situation. Okay. Situations bring out the worst in us or they bring out the best in us. Okay. You may have a great attitude, a very positive attitude, but if you are in a situation which really tears you apart as a person, which really tests you as a person, at times you know your behavior can be something very different. You may lash out at people, you may be very, very aggressive in your conduct, in your behavior. So this is the difference between attitude and behavior. Attitude is more human and behavior is more inborn. What is the attitude? It's a person's mindset, and behavior is the outward expression of attitude. So what you think about is how you will behave. Okay, so it all boils down to your thoughts, your emotions, your feelings, and that is what comes out as behavior. So attitude is what you think or feel, and behavior is what you actually do. So if you only think and feel, you will not do anything, right? So your behavior is an outward expression of that particular feeling or emotion that you're having. Okay, so this is what is in totality the difference between behavior and your attitude. Okay, now I want to talk about three very important components of attitude. And if you want to jot this down, please go ahead and do that. There are three components for this model of attitude. According to this, attitude has three components. The first one is cognitive component, the second is affective, and the third is behavioral. Now, simple words, a little jargons, if I may say, but it's something that will help you understand what exactly is attitude made up of. Okay, three things. So what is cognitive? Sabse first cognitive ke bare mein baat karte. Cognitive is the way you think about certain facts. So it's factual. It's controlled or driven by the left side of your brain. Okay, it's about your ideas and knowledge about an object or a situation or a person. For example, you know that orange is rich in vitamins and it is good for the skin and it has a good taste. Now that's factual, right? It's driven by knowledge. Aapne kahin padha hoga ya dekha hoga ya advertisement mein suna hoga ya whatever. All right. Saver bulbs consume less of electricity than ordinary bulbs. Okay, so what is this? Again, it's a fact driven through advertisements, through reading, or through just GK, general knowledge. You may have understood what is that. So cognitive, the first thing we make up in our mind is the fact about a particular thing, is the knowledge or the idea about that thing. The second is the feeling or the emotion, which is the affective component. So once you have a knowledge about something, you put it into emotions or feelings towards it. So it can be a liking towards something or a disliking towards something positive or something negative towards a particular object, which is based on the fact. So first is fact, then is emotions and feelings. Now, you know that oranges are good in vitamin C, they're good for the skin, they're good for health or whatever. And then you come to a conclusion that I like an orange. I like saver bulb because saver bulbs are good and they save electricity. So that's a feeling or an emotion. Okay. The third is the behavioral. You understood the fact about certain thing, you have knowledge about a particular thing, it boils down to the behavior and the feeling, and then it comes up as a behavior. How an individual act towards that object, depending about what your emotions and feelings towards that particular object or person is. So what's your behavior? You know, oranges are good in vitamins. You know, they're good for health. You know, you like them and now you eat them daily. Yeah. So behavior is action oriented, which ultimately happens because of the fact or knowledge about that thing, which leads to the behavior. Which leads to the emotion and feeling, and then it leads to the behavior. So this is just a hypothetical example I'm sharing with you, but this is true for anything in life. First, you make up, once a thought comes about something, then you react by having emotions about it or feelings about it, and then it turns up into the behavioral aspect. Okay. So very simply putting this in from a psychological point of view, this is how you behave depending on your emotions and feelings. Okay. Which is driven by your situation or your surrounding or your background or your experiences in life. Clear? Suvrat and Mayuri, any questions on this?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
All right. So I'm going to share another video with you, which is on attitude building. Okay. Let me put that for y'all. Give me a second. So before we see this video, I want to understand from you, how can you build a positive attitude? What are some of the things which will help you to build a positive attitude? Anybody?
I'm staying with the right people, consuming the right content, right, like books or self-help videos, motivational videos,
mm-hmm.
and not falling for the negativity that surrounds you.
Mm-hmm.
And eating the right things, I guess, because that also affects your gut. That's all.
Yes. Yes. Very good. How about you, Mayuri? How can you build a positive attitude?
Make time to be alone. Then Sorry, exercise. Make time to be alone.
Mm-hmm.
Be aware of negativity.
Yes.
Don't do anything passively. And don't watch television passively.
All right. Very interesting.
Listen to good music and also. Yes. That's it.
Absolutely. It puts you in a right frame of mind if you just do something that you like doing, right? Okay. Lovely. So let me start this video for you. Have you all heard about Dale Carnegie? Dale Carnegie, have you all heard about him by any chance? Okay, not so much. He's again a very, very, very well-known motivational speaker and a great author. Let me just share the screen with you all. Okay, just give me a second. I'm not able to open the video. Yes, Subrat, you have a webinar. Can you push it for another 15 minutes? Is it okay?
I can go for like 5 to 7 minutes because I have to moderate that session.
Oh, okay. Sure. All right. I'm sharing my screen right now. Can you all see?
No, ma'am.
No, okay. Okay. Okay, let me sort this out after some time. Okay. So sometimes Zoom can really act a little funny when you're trying to do something and it just wouldn't open. I'm sharing the screen, but I don't know why it's not coming for you all. Can you all see now?
Yes.
But the video you all could not, right?
No.
Okay. Let me try once again.
Ma'am, screen is visible.
You can see the video link. I mean, you can see the video
YouTube homepage, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
It also gives us a great understanding about how we have to, portray ourselves, portray our personality in such a manner that we get, people to like us, people to appreciate us. And I think the biggest learning out of this video is that you need to be, in order to like other people, you have to be likable, okay? And genuinely be interested in other people's lives, genuinely respond to them in the right manner, speak, you know, when you have a conversation with them, be more interested in them. So these are small, small things you can do to really have a great personality. Because today, if you, you know, if in a conversation, you only talk about yourself, people will ultimately get bored. You have to make your conversation about other people. Be genuinely interested, honest about what they are doing. And that's what makes a great personality. Okay. It's not about you. It's about them. Make sense? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's about Dale Carnegie and his view about how to have a right kind of an attitude. Okay. And I believe Suvrat has left the meeting. Suvrat, are you there? Okay. He has to go for a webinar. So I guess he has left the meeting. Okay. Mayuri, any questions from your side?
No, ma'am. All good.
Okay. All good, right? So let's come to the last part of our session wherein we understand what are some of our negative assumptions and how you can transform them into positive assumptions. So some of the negative assumptions that you may have that, you know, based on your experiences or your past life or whatever it is, you just feel that there are certain things that you start assuming about yourself and then how you can actually transform them into positive assumptions. So Mayuri, I would want you to do this as a, you know, something at your free time, which I will not get into it right now because it will take a little time. So list this down and do it as a an assignment. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So next part of it, of our session is going to talk about how you can develop a positive attitude. What are a few of the steps which will help you to develop a positive attitude? So Mayuri, what do you think? What are some of the things you can do from your end to develop a positive attitude? What can you do to develop a positive attitude? Some of the points you all had given before, but I just want to redo this particular segment.
Honest in relationship, think of others, polite, kind to everyone, remember their manners, and fearless, friendly, respect, depend, compliment other when deserve. That's it.
Okay, so these are certainly ways in which you can develop a positive attitude by thinking in a positive manner, by making sure that you do something for others because that helps you in a positive frame of mind, right? And also, instead of cribbing and complaining, think about the good things that you have been blessed with, okay? It's the most easiest thing in life is to crib and complain. I don't have this, I don't have that, and to be jealous of other people's success. But that is not what is what will help you to develop a positive attitude. If you know of somebody in your friends or family or relatives who are doing good, who are doing better than what you are doing, then it's absolutely okay. But to get jealous of that would be being a very less person or having a very small heart. So rather to have a positive attitude, think good about others, make sure if people around you are doing well and are successful, be happy for them, bless them. I think that's very, very important to have a positive attitude, okay? And do good things for others, because only once you think selflessly, do things for other people, that is when you get that positivity, that happiness, that peace, that joy, okay? So that these are some of the things which can definitely help you to develop a positive attitude. I would also recommend two or three things: writing a journal. Okay. So if you have a journal, you can write down your thoughts at the end of the day, what went well, what didn't go well, what you can do to better your day. So these are small, small things like writing a journal, reading a good book, whenever you get the time, read at least one book a week. That's something which all leaders do, which people who are successful, they read one book a week. Okay. So leaders are readers.
Yes, ma'am.
So whenever you get a chance, do read a good book, which will help you to put you in a positive frame of mind. Listen to music, de-stress yourself, do meditation, yoga, whatever will help you to be in touch with yourself, be in touch with your soul. Very, very critical is to introspect also. So end of the day, spend half an hour with yourself or 15, 20 minutes or whatever time you can give to yourself. Just be by yourself, minus any family member, minus technology, just you know, lock yourself in a room and just be with yourself. Okay.
Okay.
Go to the garden, walk a little bit. Being around nature also helps you to put in a positive attitude. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So,
sure.
Fantastic. So, what is the summary and the action plan? What are the five most important things that you have learned today, Mayuri? Any four or five important things that you have learned about attitude?
Ma'am, cognitive component attitude and affective component attitude.
Components?
Behavior. Positive and negative attitude.
Okay, these are what you have learned. Okay. And the second thing, what are the two things that you are going to change about your attitude? I want you to take about 2 minutes and write that down and share it with me. What are the two things that you're going to change about your attitude? Take about 2-3 minutes.
Low emotional, constant complaining, being closed-minded. That's changed my attitude.
Okay, that was very fast. I thought you will take time to think, but you were very, immediate with it. Okay, so what are the two things you want to work on? You want to work on first is, what did you say, your emotions?
Yes.
So what do you want to change about that?
Low emotion.
Okay.
And fear. Low emotion and fear.
And fear. What about fear?
I'm not open-minded person, so lots of fear in my mind.
Okay. So you need
to change everything.
So work on your fear, Mayuri. Work on whatever. First of all, take a list. Make a list of what are you fearful about and why are you fearful about them? What is the root cause? Has something happened that has made you be a fearful person or not a very open-minded person? So you have to spend some time and think about these fears. And what are these fears stopping you from going ahead? Is it stopping you from living a better life? So you have to really be crystal clear in your mind about how you can change this fear in your life, because it's definitely stopping you to take big steps in life, right?
Yes, ma'am, sure.
All right. Yes, so that brings us to the end of our session today. We have all the participants who are not here. So only Mayuri. Mayuri, how were these 5 days of session with you? Did you enjoy? Did it value
yes,
add?
Ma'am.
It did?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great.
I really enjoy the session.
Sorry?
Enjoy the session, ma'am.
You did enjoy
I'm
the session.
Very happy. Yes.
Thank you, Mayuri, so much for your kind words. My only request to you is please take the learnings and implement these learnings. It is not just to hear it and theoretically, but you have to put it into practice. So whatever you've understood about personality, attitude, your communication, body language, grooming, whatever we've covered in these last 5 days, you have to put that into practice. So can I get a
yes,
go ahead?
Ma'am, definitely. Yes, ma'am, definitely.
Okay, great. So I'm going to put my ID in the chat box. You already have my email ID. Let me know in case you have any concerns, you are facing any issues at all to implement the learnings. Please write to me. I'll be more than happy to guide you and help you and assist you. Okay?
Thank you.
Do write in your testimonial. I think that aircrew aviator will take it up with you with regards to your testimonial and everything. Okay. So thank you so much once again for being a part of the session, and I shall see you soon.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye. Spandana, Sonal, you all want to say anything?
Oh, thank you, Richa, for wonderful training. It was very interesting and very informative, actually.
Thank you so much, Spandana. So you can follow it up with the participants about the next way forward. All right?
Sure.
Okay, thank you, everyone. Bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye.